Sorry, I want to start again. I'm sorry. Hello, and welcome to this week's episode of Real Talk About Real Estate with Peter and Nicole. What will we talk about this week?
Well, we're finally starting to see the same numbers that we were seeing pre-COVID. So I think it's time that we can focus away from the impact that COVID has had on the market. And what better time to talk about the First Time Buyers webinar? I'm hosting the First Time Buyers webinar on July 8th. That's at 7 p.m. It's online through Zoom, so you can watch from the comfort of your couch. It's a great opportunity if you think about getting into the buying market. We're going to go through all the steps involved in buying your first home. We're going to have Alex Trahoitis, a local mortgage broker, in there to explain the financing side. And really something I think you should join if you're thinking about buying a home.
Beauty. And before we move completely away from the COVID topic, let's just put up a quick graph to show the viewers that we're not making this up. You see here the first week of March, that's really when we saw the peak activity levels in terms of showing. Now lining up with what we're seeing mid-June in terms of showing activity. So yeah, at long last, we can stop talking about the impact of COVID, at least in terms of the real estate market in this area.
And the number of offers registered is still on a very healthy trajectory upwards.
Meanwhile, the number of new listings is staying roughly about the same.
Still so, hasn't caught up.
No, it hasn't. So I think that would mean probably if you're a seller thinking about.
Yeah, really. I mean, if you're on the fence about listing your home because you're waiting around for the market to really explode, this is a fantastic market.
We're here. Yeah.
And we're in a very hot spring market, and we've dug ourselves out of the hole that we were in COVID. So I would reconsider if that was something you were thinking about.
It is a great time to put your house on the market. The demand is just nuts. In terms of demand, it's crazy competition still. Mm-hmm. That's taking off. So I thought in light of all this competition, we could talk a little bit about what we would do to strategize in a multiple offer situation.
Yes, and there's essentially three ways to strengthen your offer when you're in a competitive circumstance. Price, terms, conditions, and then the actual closing date.
And with regards to price, we would always thoroughly educate our clients so that they're never overpaying. Then it just becomes a decision of the client figuring out a number that they're comfortable with and sort of putting that best foot forward, but certainly backed by sales data to support that.
So in a competitive situation, if you can control the closing date on your end and sort of bend to the will of whatever the sellers need for their closing, and it doesn't cost you anything, that's a huge advantage to have over other buyers that maybe haven't sold their house and have to have a super far out closing date, or especially if you're competing on a vacant house that, you know, they want a really tight listing. Having control of that closing date can give you a big leg up over the competition.
Absolutely. When it comes to the home inspection condition, one way we can work around that is to have what's called a pre-inspection. So that's essentially a home inspection before the offer date. And that can either be done with a formal inspector or maybe someone you know who is in the field and could offer some insights in terms of the structural components of the house, then that allows you to go in without that inspection condition, and that's one way to really strengthen an offer.
Yeah, a lot of these buyers, the way that they're winning these competitions is they're going in without conditions, so they're satisfying their conditions beforehand. A lot of people are under the misconception that they're going in blind without any financing and without doing any look over of the home with the home inspector. But what they're really doing is they're doing their inspection in advance of the offer date, so they know that there are no major issues with the house, and then they're sorting out their financing. If you can have a pre-approval certificate before that offer date, and you can actually have your mortgage broker crunch the numbers on that specific house, look at the taxes and the running costs of the home, and give you an approval on that house specifically, so you're confident that your financing is in place before you actually make the offer in competition. It's a huge advantage over people who are in the dark on that by the time that offer date comes.
Yeah, and let's say it's a situation where we absolutely have to have one condition in or another. There's still an opportunity to strengthen it by reducing the actual conditional period.
Yes.
So it might be it is standard to be 5 business days, but maybe we could get it done in 3 days or 2 days exactly. or even 24 hours, which would give you a leg up over someone who, you know, has a conditional period of 5 business days. Anyways, shifting gears, fact or fiction, Peter, mortgage insurance covers the borrower in the event that they are unable to pay their mortgage for that month.
I think that's a big misconception that some people are running around with, and I've heard it coincidentally a few times in the last couple of weeks. So the mortgage insurance is not there to cover the homeowner in the event that they default on their mortgage. So that's fiction. The mortgage insurance is there to cover the lender. That's the way that they are able to do these high ratio loans, to cover the enormous risk that comes with that when people are putting down less than 20%. I know it sounds odd to pay insurance for a lender that doesn't really cover you, and it is odd, but it does allow you to leverage yourself and do well in the real estate market. And it also helps keep those interest rates as low as they have been in the last few years. I've got a fact or fiction for you. I heard that you were in a car accident on your way to a showing.
That is a fact. It was a thunderstorm going through an intersection, and the lights were out, so did the whole four-way stop thing, but the driver coming from the other direction did not. T-boned me. However, fortunately, my client was following behind me and was able to witness and attest to the fact that it was not my fault. So once the police got there, the tow, everything, I jumped in my client's car and we carried on to the showing. A little bit late, but it still happened.
But you still made it there.
Yeah.
That's hilarious. I think that's a wrap.
I think so. Thanks for tuning in. And remember, be kind to one another. We're all in this together.
Have a great weekend. Cheers.